I'm sitting at my desk in the second floor office loft, having a drink and cleaning my gun, when I hear the footsteps running, not walking, up the wood stairs. Heels, I tell myself. Most definitely high heels. I set the semi-automatic onto the desk, grab the bottle of Jack, do my best to shove it into the bottom drawer. But she's already entered the office before I can manage to get the bottle from desktop to bottom desk drawer. Moonlight, the slow on the draw. Fuck it, I whisper to myself, and set the bottle back down on the desk where it belongs in the first place. In fact, I set it right beside a sealed envelope that contains a summons and a set of divorce papers. They're supposed to go to a lawyer who works in the high rent district down on State Street. I might have delivered it during normal business hours, but my client requested that I deliver it to a certain downtown Albany address at a certain hour of the early evening, when for certain, he'd be shacking up with his illicit affair. Sounded like a decent enough idea to me, even though it meant I'd be working late. Again. But as usual, I badly needed an injection of cashish into a thoroughly hemorrhaged bank account.
Can you help me? She says out of breath. Help me, please.
First thing I notice, besides her panicked state, is how attractive she is, with her long, dark hair all mussed up, big green eyes, long legs, nice rack. All of it neatly packaged in a tight, sleeveless, lime green dress that shows off gym-toned arms covered in tats. And those heels? Stilettos. Red. My favorite kind. What is it you need? I ask. As you can see, I'm kind of busy.
I've just been robbed, she says. Or, I mean, I'm being robbed.
Some of the mascara painted around her eyes is running down her face along with her tears. She's really upset, and if my eyes don't deceive me, a little strung out. Why don't you call the cops, I suggest. And what did you say your name was again?
I'm Carissa, she says. And you're a detective, aren't you? It says so on the sign nailed to the wall downstairs.
I should learn to lock the door at night. Yeah, Carissa, I say, leaning back in my swivel chair. But I'm private. It's not like I can arrest whoever robbed you or is at present robbing you. She takes a step forward, inhales, exhales. When she pouts with those thick red lips, my heart sinks into my stomach.
I can't exactly go to the police, she says. Not in my line of work.
A light bulb flashes over my head. Sometimes my brain doesn't always work as quickly as it should. And I'm lucky to be alive, truth be told. Not many men can live after attempting to blow their brains out. But I was lucky to get away with screwing up the suicide attempt. In the end, just a piece of .22 caliber hollow point lodged itself inside my brain, right beside my cerebral cortex. As for the medical prognosis, situation inoperable. Major problem these days is I could die at any second. The lesser problem is that during times of stress, I sometimes make the wrong decision. The fucked up decision. For instance, right now, right this very second, I am fully aware that I should do the right thing and tell this hooker to buzz off, that I should concentrate on the task at hand and deliver those divorce papers to the specified party at the appointed hour. But instead, my eyes lock on this damsel in distress, this castaway. Her green eyes pull me in as she slowly crosses the wood plank floor, her heels providing the rhythmic drumbeat to her swaying hips. When she comes around the desk and positions herself behind me, her long fingers and red painted nails pressing against my chest, I hear that little voice inside my head telling me to kick her lovely heart-shaped ass right out the door and down the stairs. Absolutely nothing good can come of this. But then, there's the voice inside my other head, screaming at me to bend her over the desk, pull her skirt up, yank her panties down, and enter that most lovely of warm, wet lovelies. Do it before I change my mind.
Can't you please help me, Mr. Moonlight?
She says in the saddest, heartbreaking voice you ever heard.
That is your name, isn't it? Moonlight?
I have another job to take care of, I confess. Can't yours wait a little while?
He's in my place right this second. If we leave now, we can catch him in the act. Please, I'm only down the road. It won't take you but a few minutes.
She rubs her hand down until it's rubbing my hardness through my black jeans.
I promise to make it worth your while, big fella,